Hi everyone, this is LAR Games, and today I'm watching the three Sumeru preview teasers that I didn't watch earlier. I know I'm a bit late on that, but it was calculated. Today is actually the day that Genshin 3.0 comes out. It did come out already, everyone's already playing it, but I'm watching the teasers first, before I even do my dailies. So hopefully I hurry up before I miss today. And yeah, I also have some demos that I haven't watched, so I need to do those as well. So I'm gonna be watching all that, before I play. So without any further ado, let's see what these teasers showed. Oh, a new kind of, treasure hoarder type. Ooh, another flower boss. Oh god, that looks so good. Yeah. Wonder what's gonna happen with that.
I have no idea how this is gonna work.
I've been playing Mario Odyssey, and that bouncy flower reminds me of it.
举例来说, 在原神当中, 我们玩家已经见到过的感电现象, 它其实是一个符合玩家认知的日常现象。
Why are they using Lisa for this? So this is just going to be in the game now. That's interesting. It's like a fundamental gameplay change that affects even like early areas. Of course, burning is still there.
一部分具有草元素特征的目标，通过使用水、火、雷等元素与之交互，可以让不同的状态之间发生转换，从而产生不同的互动效果。
Oh, so you only bounce if you use the specific effect.
根据自身所处的环境和受到的元素效果不同，怪物会在不同的状态间来回转换。Oh,
that seems like it might be annoying.
在特定的状态下击败它们，还能获得罕见的特殊材料。
Great, more things to collect. That was an interesting transition.
希望草元素玩法的加入可以给玩家带来新奇而又有趣的体验。Okay,
so this is all about the Dendro. Alright, here we go, the second one. Of rain and sand. So far we've been seeing a lot of the like lush area of Sumeru, but I do want to see what the desert area looks like. Ooh, look at that. God, it looks so freaking good! That forest looks amazing. It looks like a legit forest. The like Whispering Woods and stuff have nothing on that.
它含有雨林和沙漠两大部分。Ooh,
the desert. Yeah, we haven't seen the desert. At least I haven't.
非常多，主要体现的是当地特色、核心主题以及幻想处理这三部分。雨林部分的风貌给人的感受就是山峦连绵。
That looks amazing. Oh my god.
雨月的柱状形式，稻荠的横切印。It's
like a combination between like the lush aspects of Mondstadt and the mountainous, like terrain of Liyue.
结合古代巨树，贯穿在整个地块。 植被方面，我们找了非常多当地特色的植被做参考。Local
plants.
By local,
I guess he means our world. Ooh, there's the desert. Look at that. Oh my god. That makes Breath of the Wild's deserts look awful. Oh my god, look at that. Oh wow, these interior like cave locations look amazing as well. This is really good looking. Are they this good at making environments? I don't understand. So far, I don't see anything super annoying, like environmental debuffs, which I... Oh my god, look at that! Giant, like, clovers. Oh, that is so cool. This is kind of spoiling a lot of the landscape, though. I don't know. Oh, you can see the clovers from far away. Oh, this is going to be so awesome. She is very attractive. That looks so good. We saw this area in the 3.0 trailer. Ecological zone. Look at those! That's very Morrowind. That's better than Morrowind. In terms of, like, use of mushrooms. Use of giant mushrooms. It's better than Skyrim, too, which had, like, Blackreach. Look at this! Oh, and the transition between the desert and the lush area? What is this? Oh my god. This environment is like, oh my god. It's almost impossible to... Wait, what? Oh, there's two of them. This one was amazing. I really like seeing all the environments. I wonder what the third one is going to be about. This one just blew me away. That was so good. All right, well, let's move on to the last one. What was the title? Prelude to Wisdom.
须弥是崇尚智慧的国度，国家的种种事务，如今正由教令院来处理。正如道七篇中八
十
所提供的情报，
so this is more having to do with the
知识
setting.
在须弥是作为一种资源来被管理。而用来实现这一点的是由
Of course, the NPCs look exactly the same as every other NPC in the game. That's still disappointing.
还有一个很有趣的点是，在须弥，大部分的人们，尤其是成年人，似乎都是不会做梦的，所以也有了须弥人不会做梦这样的说法。
That's concerning.
而当地人也会认为这是一种理性与智慧的象征。
There's something dark underneath that.
须弥森林恰到好处的湿度和土壤，非常适合蕈类的繁衍。为了增加繁衍和保护菌群的能力，蕈类发生了进化，形成了一个全新的物种——蕈兽。最高级的蕈兽更是进化出了很强的动物性，具有领地意识。
Is that an enemy?
攻击性。丛林中也栖息着各种各样的动物，其中也有不少神奇的生物。
These are so interesting.
我们还会遇见一个新的势力，镀金旅团。他们是来自沙漠
的treasure hoarders.
不加入任何国家势力，而是以自己的智慧和力量。
Oh no, never mind. They have
雇佣兵，在丛林之外的广袤沙漠中。
They have
掩埋着
bases and stuff, so they seem to be an actual faction.
有守卫着那些被黄沙淹没的古代秘密的超级机器。
Yeah, those are expected.
也有受到这些事物影响。
Look at those temples, they just look amazing.
作为应对危机时最后的威慑手段，具体是什么，就让我们拭目以待吧。
主角在须弥的旅行同样会邂逅各种各样的伙伴。
And of course,
作为
you gotta pick up waifus,
学者型的
角色 part of the core aspects of the game.
比如作为生
轮派的学者 well, that, not that one, that one's not a waifu.
正在担任巡灵官的提纳里
wish it was.
在奥摩斯港邂逅出身教令院支论派的艾尔海森。此外其他各方势力的角色也会与主角
I'm looking forward to that dancing character in the 3.0 trailer.
比如作为沙漠子民隶属镀金旅团的雇佣兵迪西亚。还有毒癖西境在须弥这样的智慧与理性的国度追求艺术和舞蹈的一路而随着旅行的继续神秘少女大西达还有大风地官赛诺等角色也会依次登场至此为止旅行者的脚步终于将要抵达须弥不论是沿途的风景还是身边的旅伴都将会是全新的体验我们衷心希望可以带给大家一场值得期待的冒险
All right, this one wasn't as impressive as the second one. Just some setting stuff, which I would have rather just experienced in the game's intro to Sumeru, but that's fine, I guess. Yeah, now I'm going to watch some character demos. Hope you enjoyed my reaction to these three preview teasers. I did them. All right, well, that's it for this one. Thanks for watching. See you guys next time. Bye.